Welcome to Open Music Sessions. I'm one of your hosts tonight, Nicole Ryan.
And I'm Daniel Reskin. Welcome, Denver, and the rest of the world.
So tonight, Open Music Sessions is a monthly show Open Media Foundation puts on every month, every first Friday, in collaboration with Denver Open Media members.
That's right, and this is our big monthly showcase to show you just what the studios here can do. All of the equipment, all of the professional production staff quality, the skills that you can learn here. This is our big monthly party to show it off.
Yeah, and if you're at home, you're watching on 57, Denver Comcast 57, and 881 HD.
Ooh, yeah. How are we looking in HD?
Yeah, where are we
What's
at?
Up, HD people? How are my pores?
If you're driving around in Denver, you're probably listening to us on...
Yes, on... Oh, don't you think I won't remember?
I don't.
104.7. KOMF, that's right.
Yep,
that's keeping you comfy.
Denver Open Media
that's
Radio.
That's comfortable.
It's
yeah.
comfortable.
That's our new radio station, 30 days in.
Yes.
And it's content all produced right here in Denver by Denver people. You can be a part of it. You can hear yourself on the radio with your friends. How cool would that be?
That's pretty cool.
Make some stuff with
we're
us.
We're on radio right now.
We're on the radio.
Yeah, we're on the radio.
Pay attention. Watch the road. All right? Keep signaling. People are pretty polite here in Denver. I've been enjoying that, but don't get too involved in the amazing entertainment we have tonight.
Yeah. The amazing entertainment tonight. We've got The Take.
The Take. Fantastic band.
Yeah, they're later in the night. And then we've got an amazing comedian.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
And I happen to know that he is a very funny man.
Yeah, do you?
Yes, Mr. Zach Maas is going to be here to grace us. That's right. With us, with his comedic stylings, his FCC appropriate comedic stylings, like every comedian loves to do. So look forward to that.
Yeah, and then we'll also have a nonprofit spotlight. I'll call up our AmeriCorps Vista, Kelsey Mitschke.
Yes.
She's going to be interviewing that tonight.
Yeah, let's get
that
on the way.
Come on up.
Let's get our
yeah.
spotlight going.
Hey, Kelsey.
Hey.
How's
Kelsey.
It going?
Really good. Really good. Really good. I'm really excited to do this nonprofit spotlight tonight.
Right. It's all you, right?
What?
Or are you going to ask her some questions?
Sure. We can ask you questions.
All right.
Yeah. Well, as we're waiting for someone to come up here, right? Who's our nonprofit spotlight tonight?
Yeah. So our... First off, let's intro the Nonprofit Spotlight. Nonprofit Spotlight is our opportunity to give it up for amazing community members, amazing organizations doing amazing work in our community. So if you know a deserving organization, individual, anyone, let us know because we'd love to have them on Open Music Sessions. So tonight we have Simone Johnson, who's the social media and marketing director of the Colorado Black Arts Festival, which is next weekend. So I'm really excited to chat with her about what that is all about and get a chance to tell you all about the opportunities next weekend.
So let's have her come on up.
Yeah, let's welcome her.
We'll leave it.
Hey, Simone, how's it going?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm really well, thank you. So next weekend, I'm so excited, but let's talk about just what is the Colorado Black Arts Festival?
Sure. So the Colorado Black Arts Festival is an annual summer festival that we... the community here in Denver holds in Denver City Park every summer. And our goal is to increase the level of awareness that Black arts and culture has made to our Colorado community and also society at large. So this year's festival, like you said, is July 8th through 10th. That's next weekend. It'll be held in Denver City Park, and it is green, family-oriented, free, and open to the public.
Free, my favorite word. So cool and so important that we especially recognize, you know, Black arts and culture because it so often gets erased in our society.
Yeah, totally.
And I know this is the 30th anniversary, right?
It is. So this is our 30th anniversary, and our theme for this year is Origins. That is to pay tribute to a very influential member here in our community who passed away last year. His name is Leonard Scotty Scott, and he was the KUVO radio host. And so we are honoring him this year.
That's so great. So how has the festival changed since it first was conceptualized in 1986?
Sure. So in 1986, it was started by a small group of artists here in Denver who felt that there was a lack of opportunity both for visual and performing artists in Denver. It began as the Denver Black Arts Festival, and we've since grown to become the Colorado Black Arts Festival. And so we have some things that have been around since the inception, for example, our People's Market, our Visual Arts Pavilion, things like that. Those will be going on. And then we also have some new things that we've added. One in particular, the Youth Fest. We just started the Youth Fest last year. This will be our second year. And it is an extension of the Black Arts Festival. And it is meant to provide a medium for younger artists to showcase their talents.
That's so cool. That sounds so exciting. And what's in line for the rest of the schedule? What else can we look forward to?
So if you want to come to the People's Market or the Visual Arts Pavilion or our food court, that'll be going on basically all weekend. We do have some things that are a little bit more timely. So we have our Boogaloo Celebration Parade, which happens every Saturday. Saturday the 9th, it will happen at 10 a.m. It starts at 22nd and Downing, and it'll end inside the festival. We also have three stages with live performances. So on Saturday, on Kumba, our main stage, we'll be having reggae and R&B. And then on Sunday, on the main stage, we'll have R&B and jazz. We also have a gospel stage that will be playing gospel music all weekend. And then the Youth Fest performers, the younger performers, will be playing on Friday and Saturday.
Such a great lineup, like truly something for anyone.
It definitely is, yeah.
Cool. And I know you guys are still looking for volunteers, right?
We are. So if you want to get involved, essentially what we're looking for is help just tearing down, setting up, helping with some logistics. And then we'll also have some activities. So at our Children's Pavilion, we have different activities for young people, bead making, mask making, things like that. So just helping with some of the activities that we have going on.
Awesome. So you can get your workout in the morning, and then you can get your creativity on.
Yeah.
I love it. Did you say how we can contact you if we're interested in volunteering?
Yeah. If you want to volunteer, you can contact us at info@colbafweb.org. That's C-O-L-B-A-F. And then you can also find a sign-up form right on our Facebook page, too.
Awesome. Speaking of social media, what other platforms are you on? How can we find you on Facebook, Twitter?
Yeah, so we are on Facebook and Twitter. Our Facebook is facebook.com/Colorado Black Arts Festival. And then our Twitter handle is CO Black Arts Fest. And then our website is colbaf.org.
Awesome. All right, so you all, this is next weekend, July 8th through the 10th in City Park West. It is completely free, family-friendly, and green. So come out to the Colorado Black Arts Festival. It's going to be a blast, tons of opportunities, and opportunities to get involved with volunteers as well. And you can find out all the information at www.colbaf.org. And I think we have a video, right?
Yeah, we have, this video is actually from last year. You can find the one from 2016 on our Facebook page, but this is a video of the 2015 festival and then the Boogaloo Parade as well.
Awesome, let's check it out and roll that video.
Colorado Black Arts Boogaloo Celebration Parade is July 9th. It starts at 10 a.m. The route is from 22nd Avenue along 21st and York to Denver City Park West. There will be floats, dancers, and drill teams with a classic car show. Come out and have fun and food for all ages. The Colorado Black Arts Festival Boogaloo Celebration Parade, July 9th at 10 a.m., Denver City Park West, our origins. Rock steady. It's the 29th annual Colorado Black Arts Festival celebration in Denver City Park West, July 10th through the 12th. Come on down and enjoy the parade, the music, the dance, the food, and of course the art. It's a fun and exciting time for all ages. Come on down to one of Denver's oldest arts festivals.
On Sunday, July 12th, featuring Denver Songbird on her love tour, Chironet.
Rock steady.
Welcome back. That was the Colorado Black Arts Festival. Again, they're looking for volunteers. Go check out their website. It'll be a great event next weekend. Next up, what do we have?
Oh, we've got arts of a different kind today, and of a hilarious kind, because it is time for the comedy segment of our program tonight. Are you all ready for some comedy?
Yeah!
We're going to get that energy up. Us comedians feed off of your comedy, off your energy like vampires. So we appreciate any noise and this whole thing. Very excited to introduce our comic tonight. He is one of the hosts of a very popular podcast, Whiskey and Cigarettes. It's actually the most popular podcast about podcasts. And just got back from some great shows in Chicago. So everybody, give a great round of applause for Zach Maas. Woo!
Oh, it's good. It's good to be here at Open Media. Make some noise for your hosts, everybody. What a fun time. Everybody make sure and check out the black arts. My favorite black art, witchcraft, probably. Another black art I really like, alchemy. No, that's the dark arts. Shit. Oh, man, I already swore. And I promised I wouldn't. Okay, so I just found out when I got here that I have to be FCC clean, so we're going to do the best that we can. As Daniel mentioned, I did just get back from Chicago. It was a good time out there. I got done with a show out there, and I went to go sing some karaoke in a karaoke bar, and I went and I sang a song, and I sang it real well, and I did a good job, and I got off stage, and this very beautiful woman said, hey, Daddy, how are you doing? And I was real confused because I'm not usually hit on by this attractive of a woman just randomly. And she said, I know that was your song that you just sang up there. I know that was your song. And I was like, so you think I'm the kind of rock star that comes and sings his own song in a karaoke bar? That's who you think I am? And she's like, I know that was you. I know it was you. And what was really weird about it was the song that I sang was Bob Seger's Night Moves. She obviously not a Seger fan. But no, I told her, no, I'm a comedian. I do stand-up comedy. And she responded by making a vomiting noise and then leaving. That's why I open for the rock stars. They're more popular than me. It was better than the last time I was in Chicago. The last time I was there was I had to go out for my grandma's funeral. She lived a long life. She's an awesome lady. Love her to death. But I do have some advice. If you ever have to go to your grandma's funeral, do not be a pallbearer. Whatever you do, do not be a pallbearer. Because after that, every time you pick something up, all you can think about is how many dead grandmas it weighs. I helped a friend move a couch the other day. It weighed probably two dead grandmas. You don't want to think about that every time you're bringing the groceries in. You know, you don't want to think about that every time you're bringing in the groceries in. Like, oh man, I bought a whole dead grandma's worth of groceries. You don't want to know how long you could have eaten off of your dead grandma, right? It's about 2 weeks. So there's been a lot of talk about catcalling in the last few years, and if you're not familiar with catcalling, it has a lot of different names like hollering or sexual harassment. And me personally, I'm actually very sympathetic to the ladies on the whole catcalling thing because from behind, I look like a cowgirl with a butt that won't quit. And every time I hear, damn, that won't quit, and this turns around. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I make you feel uncomfortable? Oh, poor you. Poor you. Now, I've gotten all kinds of calling in my life. Where I grew up in South Dakota, sometimes people would yell, cut your hair, you hippie. Or one time someone yelled, cut your hair, you queer. And I thought, you're the one yelling hair advice from a moving vehicle, all right? You might want to think about, just be a stylist, just do it. Follow your dreams. Now, I am from South Dakota originally, and the last time I was going back there, I decided, I'm going to take some pot with me. You know, I'm from Colorado. It's legal. You know, I want to go have a good time on my trip back home. I'm not afraid of them. I'm not afraid of them at all. I'm totally going to take some weed home. I'm so not afraid of them that I'm going to buy empty pill capsules from the vitamin cottage. I'm so not afraid of them that I'm going to grind up my weed and put it inside of those capsules. I'm so not scared that I'm going to see how many empty ones I can eat at one time. Which is about 10. I can eat 10 empty capsules. I'm so not afraid that I'm driving 64 and a 65 through Wyoming. I'm not scared at all. And I drive by a cop, and he sees what I look like. For those of you on the radio, I look like a stereotypical hippie that's better dressed. But anyways, he sees me and immediately just pulls out right behind me and proceeds to follow me for 47 miles through Wyoming. I can see him in the rearview mirror go like, damn it, he's going 64 and a 65. Oh, he's going to screw up. He's going to screw up. When this happens, I'm freaking out. I'm like, oh, my God, he knows. He knows. I have all this weed and pills. I'm going to actually have to eat all this pot. Oh, no. God damn it. I shouldn't have stopped at the Taco John's in Wheatland. Why did I do that? But after about 25 miles of him following you, you start to lose it a little bit. You start making direct eye contact with him in the rearview mirror, and you're like, do it! Do it! I dare you! Pull me over! Pull me over! You're just fantasizing about him coming up to the car and being like, excuse me, sir, I noticed the way that you look. I noticed your Colorado license plates. Where's the marijuana at? And just looking over and being like, I already ate it all. Should have pulled me over 49 miles ago. Now, this hair gets me into trouble a lot. Gets me into trouble a lot. A few years ago on Christmas Eve, I went to Wu-Tang Wednesdays at the Squire Lounge to get my Christmas Wu-Tang in. I was outside kind of minding my own business, and there was this woman that they wouldn't let into the Squire Lounge on Colfax, which meant that she was the drunkest person in all of Denver. And she said, she like kind of started losing it and like throwing a huge fit. And she's like, screw you guys, screw this place, you know, I'm out of here, you know, screw all of you. And she goes to walk by me, minding my own business, and she just stops and goes, what the hell did you just say to me, lady? It's like, I didn't say anything, ma'am. Peace, love, and Merry Christmas, right? She responded by punching me in the strongest part of my body, which is my forehead. And all I could hear... You're not supposed to laugh that hard at that part. All I could hear, though, was the sound of her hand just breaking against my face. Just pop, you know? And she started screaming, you know, her friends were screaming, everybody was freaking out, and I'm like, everybody settle down, all right? It's Wu-Tang Wednesday, I expected somebody to bring the ruckus. But it gave me some comfort to know, you know, the following morning when she woke up and she was like, oh my God, what did I do to my hand last night? What happened? Her friends were like, you punched Jesus in the face on Christmas Eve. Well, What did he do? What did he say to me? He said, peace, love, and Merry Christmas. But he said it was Wu-Tang Wednesday. He expected somebody to bring the ruckus. And boy, his butt would not quit. It would not quit. I got married recently. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. It's crazy. You don't even realize what's happening. You know, that it's all going down till you're up there with the priest, you know, and he's standing there and he says, I now pronounce you a man in jar of pickles. I really like pickles. I'm kidding, guys. I didn't marry a jar of pickles. I would if I could. You know, I would. No, I did get out of a relationship, though, recently, and, like, we actually didn't have to break up. I figured out how to get out of a relationship with your girlfriend without actually breaking up. And what you do is you just accuse her of stealing $20 out of your wallet. Like when she comes home from work, you're like, I know you stole $20 out of my wallet. And she's like, why would I do that? I make more money than you. And you're like, no, I know you did it. I called your mom today, and she said you used to have a similar problem with her purse when you were a kid. We know you did it. Just give me the money back, and we'll pretend this didn't happen. She's like, no, you're crazy. You're crazy. And you're like, I'll call the police. I will. And she's like, fine, call the police. Go ahead, call the police. So I did. I called the police. They came and they showed up at the house. They knocked on the door and they were like, excuse me, sir. We had a report that a jar of pickles stole $20 from you. I'm just kidding, guys. I'm totally kidding. My girlfriend wasn't a jar of pickles. I'm going to have a baby, though. Going to have a baby. I found out. Thank you. Yeah, no, I called my mom and told her that she was going to be grandma until the abortion. And she got so mad at me. She said, Zach Maas, I can't believe that you knocked up a jar of pickles. So I can't have any baby dills running around, Mom. Nip that in the bud. I got robbed at gunpoint in our safe city. It's so safe here. I got robbed at gunpoint. What happened was I was making out with a girl in an alley at 4 a.m. because it's nicer than my apartment. And this guy came by and said, give me all of your money. And like, even though I had never, ever been robbed before, I could tell that he had never, ever robbed anybody before either. You know, that it was both of our first times. He was very shaky. He was very nervous, which is real scary. He said, give me all your stuff. And I immediately did, you know. I'd never been robbed before, but I did. I gave him everything. I started going through airport procedures. I was taking my belt and my shoes off, you know. And the girl that I was with, he turns to her with the gun still in my face and says, all right, lady, give us all your stuff. And she just looks at him and goes, no! He did not expect that. He's like, no. No, that's not how this works. That's not how this works. You need to give me all your stuff right now, or I'm going to shoot this guy. And I'm like, what the hell? You're going to shoot me? I already gave you all of my stuff. Shoot her. I'm a feminist. She just looks at him and goes, no. And at that point, I see him. He's like looking at his gun. He's like looking at me. He's looking at his gun. He's looking at me. And I can tell that he's thinking that he needs to shoot me now. At that point, I just kind of lost it and was like, all right, lady, give him all your goddamn stuff. And I reached in her purse, and I grabbed all of her stuff out, and I held it out for him. And he really did not expect that at all. He was like, thank you. Thank you for your help. You guys have a wonderful evening. Thank you very much. And he turned and walked off into the night. She immediately burst into tears, but not me. I was high as hell. I'd never ever robbed anybody before. Holy crap, that is such a rush. Woo, I highly recommend it. I do have the secret to being happy at any job, no matter how bad it is. Does anybody here dislike their job? All the people working here? No, the secret to being happy at any job, no matter what is it all starts with your attitude. You know, you have to wake up every day, you have to put a smile on your face, and you have to say, no matter what happens today, I'm going to steal as much as I can from this place. Seriously, when you give yourself a raise, it makes things so much more fun. I used to be in the medical marijuana industry. I was... back when it was the medical industry. I was 2014's Westward's sexiest bud tender. If you wondered where you were recognizing me from. Yeah, marijuana sex symbol up here. It's like the sex symbol of living in your parents' basement. But one of my favorite things about the industry is I got to see all the new products that came out. And one of my favorites was a marijuana suppository, which if you don't know what that is, it's butt weed. But I was thinking, like, how much different would marijuana culture be if that was the main way that people did it? Like, how much of a different time, like, going out and getting stoned with your buddies in the garage is that, you know? Like you got it? You got it? All right. Oh, man, I feel it. but I don't know if I feel it. And his buddy's like, Mom's coming home. Hurry up. Butt, pass. He's like, All right. Don't drop it. I just don't think as many people would do it, guys. I don't think we would have as many people moving to Denver if that was the case. You know, it definitely would be a different Bob Marley poster hanging in college dorm rooms. Jammin' would have a whole new meaning. The other thing I really liked was a marijuana lubricant that claimed that a woman could have a 15-minute orgasm with use of this product, that's crazy. It's crazy. I'm pretty sure if you make your O face for more than 5 minutes, it's permanently stuck that way. I'm sure it starts out nice, you know, it's like, woo. Oh boy. Oh geez. How much time's left? What, 14 minutes and 30 seconds? Woo boy. Oh geez. Don't touch me. Get your hands off me. Don't touch me. Woo, it's getting stronger. Oh boy. Google how to stop having an orgasm. This is really FCC fun. All right. Think of grandma? No, I don't want to think of grandma. No. Dial 911. Dial 911. Give me the phone. Fine, you're too embarrassed. Give me the phone. I'll call 911. Mom? Sorry, I'll call you on Sunday. 911. Emergency, help me. Help me. 12 minutes later. Do you got any more of that? That's going to do it for me, guys. I'm Zach Maas. Thank you for having me.
For a second, stay here. We got another mic right here. Everyone, one more time, give it up for our comedian, Zach Maas, tonight. Come on. Oh, thanks for being here, Zach.
Yeah, no, it's always fun to try and rewrite all your jokes without profanity on stage. It's yes. A great time.
Right, it's like cramming your soul into How did I a do? Takeout box.
How did I do?
I think aside from the first...
The first S word,
yeah,
I did all right.
Yeah, you got one out of the way right away. Just to be like, Woo. You know what, let's not worry about it. And then it was fine. Cool. And then just conceptually upsetting instead of...
Good. That I'm glad that I could still get that point across.
Yes. Yeah, see, the FCC, they can do what they can, but they can't censor the true heart of insanity.
The art. Yes. Yeah, the art of it all. That's you know, right. Once you cut away the profanity, you're just left with the art.
So we're learning a lot here tonight. So tell us about quick about Whiskey and Cigarettes. We can hear you. This is a big podcast in Denver.
You can find us at whiskeyandcigs.com. We won Denver Westward's Reader's Choice last 3 years in a row for best podcast. We've had a lot of great guests on recently. We had Greg Proops, Dana Gould, Eddie Pepitone, which are all very awesome, great comedians.
Yeah. And all the local... Awesome.
And then, like, yeah,
well.
Pretty much every local has been on. Daniel's been on.
I've been on.
We've That's had, right. Yeah, I mean, even Daniel's been on.
Even me. Yeah, so they've been that many shows, they had to sink that low. And then where can people find and follow you? And
You can find me at Zach Maas. All my social media is at Maas Comedy, which Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and that's MAAS. And then you can also check out my game show, Uncalled For.
Yes.
Which there's all kinds of cool stuff with that. America's Most Offensive Game Show, which would be great for the radio. But yeah, you can find that. You can get cool. You can get like Denver's Worst Person, the shirt.
Yes.
You can
get
that.
You've probably seen people wearing those around there. Definitely check out Uncalled For.
Yeah, you can get those at worstpersonshirt.com.
Worstpersonshirt.com and follow Uncalled For. Zach Maas, thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Dan.
Fantastic. Just throw that anywhere. And now a member, and which is awesome. Our performers here get to become members and create content, and you have a chance of becoming a member tonight, too, if you do our raffle. So be sure to check out that. There are cards right there that Nicole has. Sign it up and win a free membership and take a class. Start learning your media adventure. All right. Well, we've comeded, and now it's time to jam. It's time to rock out. Are you all ready for some music? Yes. All right, guys, can we try that again? Are you ready for some music?
Yeah.
Okay, see? You got to ask twice sometimes. I learned that at a class here. Before the next band comes on, we're really excited to premiere a brand new music video by them, and then they will perform right after. So everybody, give a great round of applause for The Take.
Swimming into an ocean, drowning in sentiment, sounding a call with instruments loudly speaking in intricate tones. I swear this world is so different from when I entered it. Maybe my comprehension is falling apart by increments. The end result is I end up feeling so impotent because I've been prevented from feeling any significance. I made appeals on the basis of human interest and angered a large consensus of people who think I'm different, like less deserving of patience when I'm presented with violence and bad intentions for cops for just existing. And if I mention or even hint at resistance, the general sense will be I deserve it if I get injured. Although resistance was central in the decision for claiming our independence from dangerous kings in Britain, like that's how America started. How's this different? I'm sure if you were paying attention, you'd probably get it. Guess we forever be marching and doing sins, collecting these ass whippings from militant cops with billy sticks. Arrest whoever would dare to question your letters, but name another profession and thanks to they are for questioning. I know benevolent cops and I expect them to separate from the devils whenever corruption's evident. Y'all make decisions determining life or death, so why would you not expect to be held to a higher precedent?
Tunes for you guys. starting to panic. The light is already leaving his eyes. And the guns salute, now the bullets tore right through. And the gun salute, how the bullets tore right through. Isn't that irony? Was I one of the good ones, cut down by a self-made treason? And the gun salute, how the bullets tore right through. And the gun salute, how the bullets tore right through. And the gun salute, how the bullets.
Thanks, guys. We're called The Take. Got a few for you. This next one's called Steady Now. It's off our first album, first track. Sort of a song about like how we all pretend to have it together, and none of us really do. My friend calls it the fraud police, so like we're all pretending to be adults, but we're not really. We're all just little kids. So I don't know if it's really about that, but maybe. Thank you.
You're buried deep, forgotten how to breathe now. Well, if you'll ever see the light of day again, then feel your heartbeat beat, dig until you can. I'll scream till you hear me out. You'll see right through me now. I'll scream till you hear me out. You'll see that I'm not so steady now.
Thanks, guys. So this next song we're going to play, we're going to feature Soul Daddy, a.k.a. Alan Brooks. Many of you might know him. So the song that was in the video that you saw was a remix of another song of ours. So we're going to try to do the remix live. We'll see how it goes. So this is a first time anyone's seen this happen.
First time ever. Yeah, I'm swimming into an ocean drowning in sentiments, down in the car with instruments loudly speaking in intricate tones. Swear this world is so different from when I entered it. Maybe my comprehension is falling apart by increments. The end result is I end up feeling so impotent because I've been prevented from feeling any significance. I made appeals on the basis of human interest and anger, the large consensus of people who think I'm different, like less deserving of patience when I'm presented with violence and bad intentions from cops for just existing. And if I mention or even hint at resistance, a general sense would be I deserve it if I get injured. Although resistance was central in the decision for claiming our independence from dangerous kings in Britain, like that's how America started, so how's this different? I'm sure if you were paying attention, you'd probably get it. Guess we forever be marching and doing sittings, collecting these ass whippings from militant cops with bloody sticks. Arrest whoever would dare to question your methods, but name another profession that thinks that they are worth questioning. I know benevolent cops, and I expect them to separate from the devils whenever corruption's evident. Y'all make decisions determining life or death, so why would you not expect to be held to a higher president? this isn't a metaphor. Trying to remember whatever we fighting for. This is a war, this isn't a metaphor. Trying to remember whatever we fighting for. This is a war, this isn't a metaphor. Do whatever we can to settle the score.
Thanks, guys. That's fun to premiere that tune for you. We're going to do another one, and we're going to get Alan to freestyle on this one, so hold on to your hats.
I'll hold on to mine.
I think that's what people say. I don't know.
That's what the kids are saying. Trying to make a decision while I'm choosing my religion, fulfilling the Great Commission. I'm fishing for a different cause to the bars, and I need the gods when I'm walking for the name of God. I'm trying to pick a different route, I walk it out, trying to understand what living is all about. I doubt, I'm trying to stay strong, lasting on, getting well, and when I'm trying to pick it, making a different decision. Oh! Different way to different world, and I then have to find it a different way to grow. I'm trying to find it, then I gotta let it flow. When I'm trying to let my hand go, though I stand strong, I take a higher, take a long down the street, trying to keep you different with these amazing feats can be. I'm trying to understand, walking in the hand, give the man to the God as he's given me his plan. I try to shine when I'm standing on the mine, when I stand in the spotlight, trying to rock right. I will not fight all the things that test me, when I try to rest me, it's the type of recipe.
Go!
different place than I am from. Trying to find a different rhyme, trying to add up to the song. Trying to find my way on a different day than everything I say every single day. Trying to find a long when I'm going strong. Sing a different song when I learn a tone. Trying to run with power, never feeling down. When I start to rock a crowd, never ever now. On my own forever, on a different never, never got to clever. Trying to keep it wild, find the top of top with the rock and talk.
Thank you, guys.
Give it up, Alan Brooks. This next song is called Scars.
Thank you very much. You guys are too kind. This next song is a title track off our last album. We got tired of playing it how we played on the album, so we sort of rewrote it. So if you've heard it, there might be at least one person here who has. It'll be different this time. Andy Rex. Thank you. You guys have been too kind. If you like what you hear, check us out online, thetakedenver.com. We've got all our music's free to download. The remix is free. We got the video there, just in case you want to relive it, because it was, yeah, so that's all there. Checking with my guitarist to make sure I'm in the right key. So this song is called Light Up the Sky. I'll just let you sort of like make your own meaning with it. It's real deep.
Yeah! Thanks, guys. We are The Take. Thank you to Denver Open Media, Tony, and Maureen. Thanks, guys. You're awesome. You guys have a good night.
Let's keep it going for The Take, everybody.
Hey.
Come on. Give it up. Give it up. Oh, my goodness. You guys rocked out.
Yeah.
We're still on FCC rules, but I can just say you guys are some bad ace sons of Brexits, okay? Because you guys, sons of Brexits. We're being FCC compliant here on the cuss words. The Take, everybody. Oh, my God.
Yeah, guys, thank you so much. Sorry about your video. There was a little glitch in our control room, so everyone stay a little bit later. We're going to show their video. Before
yeah, we cut
end.
a little bit of the end off just so we could play it again at the end.
Yeah.
But, so. The Take, fantastic. Thank you for being here. And definitely check them out online. Can we get a website? Do you have a website? TheTakeDenver.com. Be sure to check them out and their music. They're already getting assaulted by wild fans. We would love to spoken to them at length. About their musical endeavors. Would you like to talk? Would you want to represent? I think it's your time. If you want to. Oh, we got to.
It's all good.
Yes. These are your instruments, not this. Right.
Got it.
Well, The Take, they've said what they had to say through music.
Great. Good job. We have a raffle. I forgot to grab the basket. I don't know if anyone can grab the basket for me.
Oh, we got the raffle time, everybody. Everybody, thank you for your enthusiasm, but the show is still going on, and we got a raffle. I love you all.
So we
but do... Pipe time!
Hi! They're right here. Look it. They're right here.
Oh, okay. Hey.
They're right here.
Hey, gang.
They're right there. So we want to thank everyone who performed raffle? Tonight. We've got Zach Maas who performed.
Yes, the comedian Zach Maas.
Yeah, we had
Zach
the
Maas
take.
Comedy. Follow him.
Yeah.
The Take. As you just saw and listened to perform.
And our community nonprofit spotlight,
yes.
The Black Arts Festival next weekend. They're still looking for volunteers.
Right, definitely check out the Black Arts Fest next weekend. I guess shout out to our sponsors.
Shout out to our sponsors.
The amazing list that I know you remembered because I sure didn't.
Yeah, we've got Westford, we've got Greater Than Collective. Oh, look, there they are. We've got Illegal Pete's.
Oh, that helps. Cheat Sheet.
Yeah. Sexy Pizza.
Oh, the sexiest pizza. So sexy, that pizza.
You want to read those?
Sexpot Comedy. Oh, near and dear to my heart. We got Lamar's Donuts, which are actually in my heart right now because I just ate them. Crazy Mountain Brewing Company. Delicious. Speaking of, offensively delicious Renegade Brewing Company. And Ratio Beer Works. I just had a fun comedy show there the other night. What a great time that was. And Weed Stream, the outdoor weed bus. Also like to have a great time in that, ASAP. So thank you to all those wonderful sponsors for making this little night happen. They're giving because they care about community-oriented stuff.
Yeah, we're very thankful. Here's our raffle.
Oh, man.
All right.
Got to reach in there real deep.
There we go.
And, oh, you don't get drama like this anymore, folks.
Woo!
And it is Bob Tim. Woo! Bob Tim, is that you? Oh, my God, Bob Tim. Congratulations.
And he's coming
to
on
you.
Up.
Come on up.
Sure,
come on, shake
thanks.
Our hand. Congratulations, yeah. Bob.
Thank you.
Is there anything you'd like to tell the people at home and all of the world that's watching?
What did I win again?
You won a free membership to here.
Open Media, oh, no, that is the greatest thing. I've wanted this for so long. Can't imagine.
Are you going to start your own talk show or any show?
My own comedian show.
Oh, we got a comic right here. The next Louis C.K. right here, everybody.
Good stuff.
Thank you. Congratulations, Bob.
All right, good.
You are the raffle winner tonight.
Woo!
And a star tomorrow.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone at home, for watching. Channel 57, 881 HD, Comcast Denver. On our radio station, 104.7 KOMF, Denver Open Media Radio. Thanks, everyone.
Have a great night. See us next month.